Thank you, choir. Now we will proceed with responding to the word with the prayers of the people. Starting with prayers of thanksgiving. And as always, you know, we'll respond, generous God, pour out your love. Does anybody have any thanksgivings today? There's one over there, Benny. Maybe a few.
I'd mentioned a couple of weeks ago about our granddaughter moving here to go to school at Waverly, and I'm just thankful again that she's so close that she's visiting with us this weekend, and we're just so thankful that we're going to be able to do that. Having moved from North Carolina, it's a little bit of a shock, but she's adapting.
All righty. Generous God, pour out your love.
Well, this weekend, Friday night, 11:59, we were blessed to have a new great-grandson born. Cassidy and Ware Chen presented us with Levi Allen. Levi come in at 6 pounds, 4 ounces, and 19 and a half inches long. We're excited to get down and see him. One thing they stressed to me was he had a lot of black hair. It's about 2 inches long, a full head. And I said, well, he done better than his great-grandpa. So, but we are very, very pleased and very blessed to welcome Levi.
Excellent. At 11:59, the stroke of midnight. Cool. Generous God.
I had mentioned to our congregation before about my son-in-law, Kevin Kugel's brother, Ken, who's only 53, having stage 4 lung cancer with mets in different parts of his body. And he just finished his first round of chemo. And when they did the scan, the results, the chemo has been working. There was one tumor they couldn't even see anymore. And then some of the tumors had shrunk, and so they're very hopeful. So they're going to be starting another round of chemo that isn't quite as strong because he's had really no quality. He's been so ill throughout this whole thing. And then they'll scan again to see how things are. So we're very glad, and I know some of you have been praying for him, so thank you.
Generous God, pour out your love. Are there any more prayers of thanksgiving? Seeing none, are there any prayers of concern this morning?
I I have two concerns. First one I'll mention is my brother, younger brother, had prostate cancer and had the surgery last week. Still too soon really to tell what's going to happen with him, but asking for your prayers for he and his family. And the other one is Inez is going to be having knee surgery on Thursday, and so I'm asking for prayers for the doctors, nurses, aides, and of course for Inez for success.
Generous God. There's one up here, Mr. Hawk.
Just continued prayers for Kim Santman. He got back to Iowa City late last week. He's been going through heavy chemo this weekend, and tomorrow he gets his transplant stem cells. And so the next 4 or 5 weeks, he's going to be in isolation. He's been just better than anybody could expect for spirits through all this, so I hope he maintains that. And keep Dale and Bev in your prayers, too. So.
Generous God, pour out your love.
Tom, I have one. I'd like to offer prayer for our country to get unified, pray for our new administration, the family, and their health. And if we can get these next 4 years or whatever we have, get the country back together. Thank you.
Generous God, pour out your love. Okay, yes, John.
I never regret asking for prayers, especially from the people of God. It's a combination of both a thanksgiving, but it turns to a concern for me. My wife and I are now living in Cedar Falls. My mother-in-law celebrated her 92nd birthday on the 7th of December. We moved on the 8th of December. And my mother-in-law passed away on the 11th of December. And my wife, for 5 years, went every night from Fredericksburg to Waverly to Bartles to help her mother get settled in for the evening. And my wife is having a little bit of a struggle, having that emptiness now, where she had that purpose in her life, and now she's feeling that loss even more. And I just ask your prayers for strength for her.
Generous God, pour out your love. Lord, meet us in the silence. Lord, meet us in the silence and hear our prayer. God of people who fish, people who stare at the night sky in patient wonder, people who daydream in solitude and silence, hear our prayers. God of artists and dancers, singers and painters and composers, of all who create, fueled by your creative spirit in us, hear our prayers. God of our justice seekers and kingdom builders, of all who strive for righteousness and work to welcome in people from the margins, who care for those who are poor and live on the streets, and for those who welcome refugees, hear our prayers. God of us all, children and seniors, help us to work hard, to play hard, and to dream bold dreams. In all we do, from day to day, from birth until death, may we be inspired to follow you and to create and love and restore as our brother Jesus did. As children of God, let us pray the prayer Jesus taught his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Let us offer our gifts, our tithes, and our offerings for Christ's work.
Thank you.
Please pray with me. We are called to follow, yet often slow to respond. God of grace, we are blessed with more than we ever need or can ever use, yet we are reluctant to part with even a portion of this abundance. As we offer our gifts to you, remind us that learning generosity is part of our call to follow the one who models your gracious nature in every word, every gesture, every day. Amen. Receive this blessing. We could play hide and seek, waiting for others to come find us. But we all go in God's light, seeking those in the world's shadows. We could stay where we are, our hearts and souls captured by fear. But we follow the one who leads us, who serve all longing for new life. We could cling to our burdens and worries, using them as an excuse to ignore those around us. But we will lay them down to join the Spirit in embracing our sisters and brothers. Amen. Please join me in singing the hymn, The Summons. And this time we will sing out of the Black Hymnal, page 2130, verses 4 and 5.